headquarters in New York this past weekend. 122 countries have approved a historic global treaty to ban the use and possession of nuclear weapons.
Can you confirm that the votes are accurately reflected on the screen? The voting has been completed. The machine is locked.
The new treaty, signatory states agreed not to develop, manufacture, test, or possess nuclear weapons. They also vowed not to threaten to deploy nuclear weapons or even permit any nuclear arms to be stationed on their territory. The historic vote last Friday came after months of talks in which the United States led the opposition to the treaty. In the end, all countries with nuclear arms ended up boycotting the negotiations. These last few minutes of the show, we're joined by Ray Acheson, director of Reaching Critical Will, which is the disarmament program of the Women's International League of Peace and Freedom. She represents her organization on the steering group of the International Campaign to Abolish Nuclear Weapons, known as ICAN. Ray Acheson, welcome to Democracy Now! Talk about the significance of what took place.
So this was a long effort to get countries to come together to develop new international law to prohibit nuclear weapons. And we're working in a context, of course, where the nuclear arms states are investing billions of dollars into modernizing their arsenals. We're in the midst of a new arms race. And they boycotted these negotiations. They boycotted all of the processes leading up to these negotiations. The United States tried to encourage its allies around the world, particularly in NATO, to boycott the talks. But despite all of that, 122 countries, as you saw, voted yes for this treaty and came together at the UN over the course of 4 weeks to negotiate it.
So what does it mean that they have voted? 122 countries is a very big deal, but it's none of the nuclear powers. So what does that mean?
Well, the treaty is actually designed not to include them necessarily. It would have been great if they had have come along, and it would have looked like a very different treaty. But given that they weren't engaged in the negotiations and that they aren't interested currently in disarmament, we needed to create something that could attack the system of nuclear weapons, sort of indirectly, getting around different